Welcome back. Before moving any further, let's review all the concepts that we have learnt during the last few steps. Angular applications are built using a number of Angular modules. There would be a custom-built Angular modules which are built as part of your application, as well as inbuilt Angular modules which you make use of. Whenever you want to reuse a component, you need to import the specific Angular module. Whenever you create an Angular component, you need to associate it with an Angular module. So Angular application is built up of Angular modules, which in turn is nothing but a set of Angular components or directives or building blocks of Angular. Each component has a template, which is basically a HTML file where typical HTML is combined with a few Angular specific things like Angular binding syntax, right? We looked at interpolation. We looked at two-way binding. We looked at event binding as well. The style is CSS part of it. The code is basically the place where we put all the data in, as well as how should we react to the view actions. So we'll put methods which help us react to the view actions. The different data binding features in Angular help us to bind the template to the code. So we are able to bind the view, the HTML, to specific data and specific events which are described in the code. We also looked at routing, which helps us navigate from one component to another. We also made use of a number of ng directives, Angular directives, ng for. We made use of ng if. We also made use of the pipes. While we learned a lot of things in the last few steps, there are a lot of things remaining as well. One of the things is, look at the design of the pages right now. They don't really look appealing. We would want to use something like Bootstrap. We would want to create a few proper menus. You don't have a proper footer. The other important thing is there is no security for the menus at all. If I just type in 4200/todos, you'd be able to directly look at the list of todos. You don't really have to log in to be able to see your todos. I don't need to really do this and go and click this to go to todos. Even without logging in, if I go to a new page and type in todos, I'll be able to still see the todos. That's not highly secure. The other thing is hard-coded logic. Right now, the to-do list is hard-coded. It's not really coming from a REST API or something of that kind. The same is the case with authentication. We have a hard-coded logic which is present in there. And there is a lot of to-do functionality which is remaining to create, right? We need to be able to edit, view, and delete to-dos and add to-dos. And we have not even started creating the basics of REST APIs with Spring Boot and Spring Security. There is a lot of work ahead of us. And in the future steps, let's focus on getting these done one by one. I'm really excited to go on this journey of building a full stack application with you. And I'll see you in the next step.